Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever in the world you are. I am in Kigamboni, Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. I hope everyone's doing well and that everyone is surviving COVID. So on today's Let's Talk, I've invited a good friend of mine. Her name is Tessie Lim to come and discuss strong woman, the meaning of the word strong woman. This is Tessie. Hi, Tessie. So I'm going to get Tessie to introduce herself. Please go ahead.
Hey, my name is Tessie Lim. I live in Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. And I'm an executive coach. That means I work with senior executives, C-suites in corporations to raise their productivity, to build leadership skills, and in general, to live their best life.
Wow.
I purposely love to work with women, and my friends and I have started something called Women Influencing Learning and Development.
Oh, okay.
So that is exciting because we believe the next wave of, not COVID, the next wave of development is going to come from women, you know, okay.
And
the world.
Mainly, you might work mainly in Malaysia? Or
yes, Malaysia and Singapore.
And Singapore, okay. Yeah, so now you can see why I invited Tessie for this talk. And like I just told her, when I wanted to do this topic, her name was like the first name, and then it just ended up being the only name because this is the person I want to talk with.
And my naughty friend didn't tell me that this was going to be the recording. I thought this was just going to be the prep show.
No. This is just Let's Talk. I'm trying to make it a little bit informal because, you know, mm-hmm. It's just things we want to talk about. Now, just so everybody knows, my credentials, I don't have any, but I'm a person.
You're a funny lady, comedian, yeah. Good friend.
Right. But I do this because I'm interested in these things and because... I'm the type of person, if something bothers me, I speak up.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's about strong women. And
yeah, and you if know, you did that in my country, you might get taken away.
You know. Okay, so the first question I want to ask Tessie about this strong woman thing, because, you know, you always see memes and people on Facebook, on social media saying, I'm a strong woman, or oh, you such a strong woman. You know, they're always stronging each other in being woman, whatever. So,
well, I think a strong woman is able to be resourceful under many circumstances. You can put her in a situation where she's got to be a family person, you can put her in a business environment, you can put her in a community environment, you can put her with men, you can put her with women, you can put her with old people and young people and children, and she will still come across holding her own and being very admirable, being someone you can admire. Do you understand?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I had to write mine down. And like for me, it's, so I'm going to read it. It is someone who has to have her life together and whatever that may mean for her, you know, like whether it's, you know, like you said, you have work, marriage, it's, you know, you have to cover the whole spectrum.
Then
someone who knows who she is and who owns it unapologetically and with pride.
Yep. And that's you, my friend.
That's you as well. Okay. And then someone who has unwavering principles.
Yes.
Okay.
That is the most important thing.
Feminine.
Mm.
Because, you know, I can be as butch as I want to be, but I think femininity in itself is already very powerful. Okay.
And then they call it the weaker sex.
I know. Well, we know that that is not true. The other thing is she has to be very secure in who she is, which is similar to what I said, but for what she stands for, but most importantly, not be afraid to speak up when necessary.
True.
And someone who can control her emotions. Not saying don't have emotions, but you must know when to keep your emotions in check and to view things logically.
Yes.
Practically. And then someone who puts herself first. Because if you're not in the right space, you know, which is the last thing. If you're not in the right space, it's you cannot help others. So a strong woman is also someone who can help others. My definition is not someone that's half naked in a post and saying, I'm a warrior, I'm a strong woman.
No.
No. That can be part of it, but it's not.
And not someone in a suit and stilettos who feels she has to prove herself to mm-hmm. a boardroom full of men.
Right. Or just prove herself, whether it be to men or women. I find that most women I know are too busy trying to prove themselves to other women. Forget about men, because you know, men, they're already happy that you just showed up. You know, but they always have to prove themselves to other women.
Yeah. In my country, there are women activists. One of them is Ambiga Srinivasan, a lawyer. She is Indian by race, Malaysian by nationality. And because Indians are minority, I feel that in order for her to have come up and become such a renowned legal person or solicitor in an all-male environment, plus she has been given the Medal of Honor by Hillary Clinton and Madeleine Albright in those days for speaking up against unfair treatment of minorities and for women's rights.
Okay.
She has made Malaysian women proud by becoming, well, by getting on the world stage. I really admire her. She's articulate. Mm-hmm. She looks you straight in the eye and she says what she has to say. No apologies.
Right.
That's what I really like. When you can be so firm in your beliefs that you are unwavering, as you say.
Right. Yeah.
You
yeah.
Just speak your ground. Yeah. She's a good embodiment of what you say. The second lady is more like a motherly figure for me, a friend of mine. She's survived cancer twice. She's a cancer survivor. And she's raised her children. And all the time, she's never let on that because of her illness, she would want them to give her special attention. You know, she was always the one providing, even though she could have had an easier life if they had fawned over her. I think that despite the fact that she isn't well-to-do, she smiled through it all and made the best of it and still managed to inspire the people around her by her cheerfulness and, you know, by her motherliness. That's another person that I know. My third person is somebody like you, I think. Somebody like many of us girls who's not particularly like well-known, but there's so many of us who do the best we can with whatever we have and are great connectors because we care enough to reach out and to make our little space better. You know what I mean? I like to count myself among those people. We don't have a lot of resources, but we find ways and means to reach out and say hi to the person next to us and see what they need and be open to our surroundings, be approachable. Just putting people together is a great way to make our community better.
Right. Yeah. Okay, it's so weird, like your first two, one is from the legal profession and one is the maternal instinct that you admire, and which is the same with my first two. Because my first one is Judy Clark. Judy Clark is a U.S. Death penalty attorney.
Oh.
And I really admire this woman because I think it's because it's personal for me, because I'm so anti the death penalty, which is not actually that I'm anti the death penalty. I'm just so pro that everybody has to live. Everybody has the right to life. And I admire her that she can stand up and fight for the life of people who we really don't want in our societies.
Yeah.
You know, but she will stand and she will fight for them. And you know,
somebody has to, right?
Yes. And
nobody wants to be with them.
Yeah, and which I feel is the epitome of being a woman, because women are supposed to be the ones that care about life, the preservation of life, because not only do we create it, we nurture it, but also we should want to preserve it. And so I really admire her because she faces so much backlash, because, you know, you can imagine she's someone who defends the worst of the worst.
Yeah.
You know, like she defended Johar Tsarnaev, who is the Boston bomber. She defended him, you know, but that is her only case that she lost in her career, yeah, which was very sad because he's 19 years old and he was like a son to her.
So he was executed then?
No, he was not executed. He's caught, his case just got appealed and he has been taken off the death.
Oh.
Yeah, but that's again another story. But so it's, in a way,
he managed to get it. Okay. That's a win for her.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Okay, and then the second one is J.C. Dugard. J.C. Dugard, also from the U.S., was kidnapped and tortured and used as a sex slave for years by her captor. And she gave birth to, I think, two of his children.
Oh.
And she loves those children. And this I admire.
Yeah.
That where we have today women who are quite happy to just abort a child because there's some genetic defect, or because they don't want it, or because they have a career, the child is in the way, or because they have better things to do with their lives, you know, better. Mm. This is a woman who was a victim of rape.
Yeah.
And yet she loves these children because she says they are victims as well. And if one has to be punished, it has to be the man, not her.
Yeah,
and not
because the children are innocent.
Yes, they're innocent. But you know, today somehow us women have lost this quality. So that is why I admire a woman like her who, against all odds,
right,
the mother instinct is so strong that she will fight for the survival of her children.
Amazing.
And then the third woman, because it was supposed to be also us, but you've already covered that, so I had to quickly think, is J.K. Rowling.
Oh.
Yeah, because at the moment, she is standing up for us women. And women, I mean women, as in the dictionary, biological women who are of XX chromosomes. She's standing up for us. She's getting a lot of backlash from the trans community, which are XY human beings, which are men essentially, who have transitioned to women, or who have not even transitioned, but who feel that they are women. And she's fighting for our place as biological women, for our existence, because at the moment, the trans community, well, not the community, the trans activists are trying to say that we do not exist anymore, that a trans woman and a biological woman is the same thing. And she is standing firm in the biological fact that an XX human being is a woman. So I admire people like this who not just shutting up and keeping quiet because they're worried they're going to get canceled or friends are not going to like them or they're going to be called transphobic.
Yeah.
So to me, this is a strong woman.
Yeah. Lady Judge Ruth Ginsburg something. She's also very strong. Gone down history as somebody really beloved.
Yes. Yeah, so this is the kind of women I admire because they are women and they are embodying everything and presenting and representing everything that a woman is supposed to be without compromising being feminine or without fighting with men.
Yeah.
You know, it's just about...
They're not out there to win a PR campaign.
No, they just by being, they are already showing what it is,
How amazing is that? Such good role models we have.
I think it's very hard for me to find strong role models.
True.
You know, so this...
Because the lines are so blurred, you know, we get so much flack from speaking our mind. Mm-hmm. And then they say the stronger thing would have been to suck it up and remain quiet. Mm-hmm. Let's say when a man abuses you, you're supposed to grin and bear it and only keep it to yourself. Don't share it with the world. You know, you don't want to air dirty laundry. Who are you being if you were to wail and let everybody see your tears and your vulnerability? Oh dear. You know, that's what I got when I got divorced. If you were any kind of a role model, you would keep quiet. Because who wants to hear all the ways that you suffered? My thinking is if my story can inspire just one person to stand up for herself and not be abused, I think I would have I would consider myself stronger than the woman who's kept quiet.
Yeah, that's true.
Don't you think?
Yeah, for sure. And then for me, again, on my side is I get a lot of flack from other women. Not from men. I don't get from men. Men love me. I get a lot of flack from other women.
Because?
Because of the way I am. Because I speak my mind. I don't conform to... Like you said now, like if there's a divorce, then you have to suck it up. And, you know, I don't conform to all to sucking up. I do what I have to do. I make choices for myself.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't know, women always tell me to shut up. Don't be like that. Don't wear that. Don't, you know, to me, it's like, to worry about your own clothes and let me worry about my own clothes, you know?
I've been to a few healers and energy therapists and all that who say, oh no, you're attracting whatever happens to you by the vibe that you put out. I said, I didn't ask to be beaten. I didn't ask to be slimed, you know, or scream that. I didn't put out any vibe. There's nothing on my forehead that says attack me. So sometimes I think we have to be so clear about who we are that we cannot people to slap on labels on us like, oh, you are faulty, you are, you know,
it's your fault.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. You have to wash it off and say, you know, delete, this is nonsense.
Right.
I didn't do anything to attract bad things.
Yeah.
Happened by itself that, you know.
Right.
Things happen. I didn't ask to be attacked. I didn't, you know.
Yeah, because especially because you have no control over the other person.
No.
So there's nothing you can do.
Absolutely reject that kind of thinking.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I say, I can sit on a mountaintop and be very, very calm, but then you put me in the streets of New York and the slums of the Bronx, and I think you'll find me a very, very different person.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because everybody relates to the to their environment.
Right, right. Yeah, yeah.
You
yeah.
cannot say, oh, you have to be calm, you have to chant, you have to say your affirmations daily, and suddenly the bubble will be around you and you'll be protected.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, remain strong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I see you have some questions that you would like to ask.
Okay, so I wanted to know what the prejudices are around strong women. These prejudices, are they just around gender, or is it more of an equality issue?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we spoke about it a little bit now.
Yeah, yeah. So,
what do you think?
People are prejudiced against women who are too outspoken because they think that a woman's place should be in the kitchen. You should be raising your family. A woman should be seen and not heard, being arm candy, being the trophy wife. That's how I want my woman to be.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But then when they go and have an affair, it'll be to the total opposite.
Right, right. Yes, yes, yes.
But then when they come home, they want to have that plain, that very homey woman being the mother of my children.
Right, right.
All that kind of prejudices that men have, that we have to be in pockets so that we can be acceptable.
Right, right. So would you say it is gender, and would you say it is, what was the other thing you said, equality? Let me see, what did you say?
I just think it's just culture. And,
culture.
And upbringing, you know, how people put on labels and limitations.
Right. Yeah, I think it is culture, because you see, like everything you mentioned here, like I have never experienced that with any man that I've been with. Because my personality, because I'm quite manipulative and conniving. So I can play many roles. So I can, you know, I totally understand that part of the art of being a woman is knowing when not to be too much of a lady. I get that. So I can play roles I can be that woman when you come home, you know, I'll play that game. I can also be that dynamic woman that you want. I can also be eye candy, that's what you want. And it could also be because, you know, it's nature of my job. I'm a showman, so... Yeah, so that has never bothered me to have to play these roles. I don't think it's so much of a gender thing. It would be more of a cultural thing, I think. So it's not gender. And then also, but like I said before, my problem is mainly with other women. There's never been with someone that I'm with, like whether it's my husband or boyfriend or just other men that I work with. But also because in my line of work, I mainly work with the LGBTQAI, the alphabet community, because they've already taken all the letters of the alphabet. And they have a different energy. So the kind of, the kind of prejudice that I get from them would be different. It's more of a jealousy. Because as a woman, I do tend to get preferential treatment, even if they are supposed to be the, you know, the transsexual or the transvestite or whatever, because that's how it is in our line of work. And then because I'm also very butch, I can be very strong in the way I work, so I can still be very manly. So
do you think these LGBTQ community have to be stronger than regular people? And I don't mean that in a negative way.
No. I think
because of how prejudiced society is in general.
You know, actually in Malaysia, I don't even feel that there's prejudice because, you know, I'm in that community and I don't see it. And even if I see it, it's very, very minute. I'd say there's more prejudices against women in Malaysia, not so much against the LGBTQI, because at the end of the day, a man is still a man in Malaysia. He still has more rights than a woman, isn't it?
Yes.
Doesn't matter how you are, you still, you know, so... Maybe in other countries, but not in Malaysia. So I don't, because I don't see that as being the case. And I don't think that the alphabet community, they have to be stronger than the rest. Because at the end of the day, everyone is just a human, you know? So there's no one more special than the other one.
Friends here who have had a lot more trouble getting work than us people, regular people.
Yeah, but this is work. Again, you know, when it comes to work, it depends on your behavior. It, you know, it depends. My own friends from the alphabet community will say that. If you're going to go for a job, if you show up looking like a man, then you have to behave like a man. That's just the culture in Malaysia. If you show up looking like a woman, then behave like a woman. And then if you are a transgendered person, if you really look very feminine, nobody's gonna care. But if you come looking like my husband in drag, it might be a problem. And I know I have that problem because people always think I'm a transgendered person. They think I'm a man pretending to be a woman.
Oh
yeah, especially when I'm dressed up.
Mm.
But it's okay. I'm okay with it. I go with the flow. Because I'm gender situational, I just go with whatever.
You're one strong woman, friend.
Well, not just me, you as well, and many other women. That's why we're having this conversation. Because what we perceive as what is strong is not what other people perceive.
I was just having a conversation with a friend today and she was bringing up my past lives and all the insecurities that are now showing up unconsciously in my daily choices. And I'm saying like, oops, stop. I'm not going to bring along all my
baggage.
Don't put it on me because that ain't me anymore. You need to be really aware that you've got to push back sometimes,
right,
and not let people dump on you their stuff.
Right.
It's their stuff. It's not your stuff. Oh my goodness. And they put you in they draw a keyhole and they want to force fit
yes,
you
into
my door so that you fit there and I'm quite comfortable with you. And then, you know, the ones who are like iffy and then say, oh, what do I do now? Who do I have to be now?
Uh-oh. Right. Yeah. Yeah, because I remember when I was younger, because I'm quite the nerd. And, you know, being a nerd and in the entertainment industry doesn't really go together. And I'm a prude. I love books, I love studying, I love politics, I like to read about religion, I love to do debates, I love intellectual conversations.
You're my alter ego, hey.
Yeah, you know, and so when you show up in the entertainment industry with this kind of character, people dump on you. Yes, they dump, they want to put you in a corner, you know, and then, but it's just because I have different interests.
One way of being strong is knowing who you are and not, feeling like you have to cave. Yeah, be who you are wherever you are.
Yeah. And I know I connected with you when we did the first time I met you at the Festival de Feminine.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, because, I don't know, because in my language it says suart suk suart. It means like, direct translation, the same type will look for the same type.
Meaning?
Because I'm like very strong and, you know, my own person. And then I saw you and it was like, yeah, she looks like that.
How to manage the perception? What do we want to see happen?
So what do you want to see happen?
I want to see in my own country, women who are not afraid to take a position when it comes to hard conversations like politics, race and religion, the hard conversations that people don't even dare to mm-hmm. have these days. It's not about talking about it. It's talking about it in a way where people don't get all riled up and being mature about, you know, having things said that will not affect you. And not many people have that kind of maturity, you know, mm-hmm. to allow other people to be different. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I'd like to see. More inclusion, more tolerance, more appreciation, and not so much hardliners.
Right.
You
right.
Woman, man, me, LGBTQ, blah, yeah. blah.
Yeah, yeah. Your first admirer. Look at her. She's strong. She stands up. She'll put herself out there, irrespective of what the outcome is going to be. And then I see, because I work online, I can see people will be willing online to speak to a certain extent, but there's no follow through. And I saw it especially with when the Ministry of Family and Health, I can't remember, that whole Doraemon issue, I don't know if you remember that.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, because I made some videos. I don't know if you've seen them about that.
Yes, I saw them.
Yeah, because I even did it with my friend who's a psychologist because she could see. I mean, even things like that. The majority of us women, we know exactly what she was getting at. Of course, her delivery was not good.
Yeah.
But we knew what she was getting at. And the other thing is, we also know that Malaysians, when you want to address serious issues with them, you cannot talk the way we are talking now. No. It has to be a slapstick. It's a very slapstick, sorry, Malaysians, but you know, this is the truth. Everything has to be like a cartoon. That's why that girl, what, Nandini or something? The Indian girl with a big dot here.
Oh, yeah.
That's why she's doing well. Yeah, because she's like a cartoon.
Yeah.
She's the epitome of the Doraemon that minister was talking about.
Yeah, and I believe that if we were in that position, being smacked around, I think we would do everything and anything we could to stay the
dude
hell alive.
Dude said swing... from one side of the room on the other side of the room with a bone through your nose and go wah, 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 like a real African, I would do it.
Yeah.
So that is why I feel women, when we talk about strong women, this is when we must be strong women, is in cases like that, when we stand up for each other. Instead, they were all breaking down this minister for saying this.
Yeah.
When we know what she was getting at.
We're trying to be high and mighty.
Yes.
Thinking that, I never happened to me. And what kind of woman would be like that? You know, poor, uneducated, and no self-esteem. Only why would she do that? They have no idea what they're talking about.
Yeah, so this is where I feel we have to... And this thing that I see a lot of people with the 2 + 2 = 5. If someone says 2 + 2 = 5, because I'm just going to leave them to say what to believe that because I don't want to cause trouble. That's where the problem starts because 2 + 2 is not 5.
Yeah.
You have to put your foot down and make it right. You're not a better person for keeping quiet.
Mm.
Right,
but people don't have hard conversations enough here. They don't have the capability or the maturity to hold a space for somebody to go off the handle a little bit and come back. Be personal about it. Interesting.
Yeah, I know. This is a let's talk. I think we
could go on and on.
Yes, we could go on and on, but I need to watch. Yeah, it's like 1 minute over time. Yeah, but I hope this helps a few people when they see this, because I'm trying to do, I want to do more of these kind of talks. And even if you can come up with more things you would like to talk about, let's do that. Yeah. Let's discuss these things, because somebody has to talk about it.
Mm.
Okay.
Let's talk.
Let's talk. So thanks. Thanks so much, Tessie, for your time and for your insights. And take care and take care of yourself during COVID.
Yeah, you too. Stay safe.
You too. Thank you very much. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.